Students, good morning everybody. Today I will start the topic, the very beginning part of the basic chemistry, that is your laws of chemical combinations. In laws of chemical combination, why these laws are there? Actually, during a chemical reaction, the various elements combine to form the various compounds, but the factor arised here is what? The number of elements or number of atoms participating or total mass of the substance reacting to form the respective products. To know all these factors, basically there are 5 laws including to explain all these things. So the first law, out of these 5 laws, the first law we are going to discuss, that is your law of conservation of mass. What is the law of conservation of mass saying? During a chemical reaction, the total mass of the reactant is equal to total mass of the products. That's why we say during the chemical reaction, neither the mass is created nor the mass destroyed. That means neither the mass is created nor mass is destroyed. Only the mass is transport from one form to another form. That means the total mass of reactant is converted to total mass of the product. So regarding that only we will discuss. First of all, the definition you write, after that one question I have written already, and that question we'll discuss, and taking to that question's answers you can solve number of questions from the law of conservation of mass. So what exactly the conservation of mass definition will write? During a chemical reaction, the total mass of reactants is equal to the total mass of products. Okay, for example, suppose you will take methane. When it is burnt in air plus O2, it gives you carbon dioxide plus H2O. If we'll balance it, then what are we getting? Number of carbon atom are here C1, and C is 1 here also. Hydrogen 4, therefore 2 hydrogen you put here, 2 a water. So now oxygen is coming 4, here 2 and plus 2 4. So you will put here 2. Now the reaction is, by equation is balanced equation. Now you will find out the number of reactants participating in the reactant side. In reactant side, the total mass of carbon is 12. Plus 4 hydrogen is 4, 12 plus 4, that equal to 16 gram. And then your oxygen is your what? 16 into 2, 32. 16, 32 into 2, that equal to 64 gram. And carbon is having here 12 plus 32, 44 gram. And then your water is your 36 gram. If you will combine all these total reactant side, the total mass is coming is 16 gram plus 64 gram, it is coming 80 gram. And similarly, in product side also, when you are going to calculate total, you make it to sum, you will get your 80 gram. So from this, what I am getting? Total mass of the reactants is equal to total mass of the products. So this completely explains about the law of conservation of mass during the chemical reaction. It has happened. No mass is extended here, no mass is lost here, no mass is increased here also. Total mass involved number of atoms participation is equal to the total mass of the product, where the number of atoms also involved in the same way. So in this way you can write the mass during a chemical reaction. Neither the mass is created nor destroyed. So this is all about your law conservation of mass. So related to it, we'll discuss this questions that I have written. If 6.3 gram of NaHCO3 sodium bicarbonate is added to 15 gram of acetic acid, then acetic acid solution, the residue is found to weigh 18 gram, and what is the mass of carbon dioxide released in the reaction? Actually, while solving this one, first of all, we will write the chemical equation. So form, what is that exactly? You see, first of all, you write the equation NaHCO3 plus CH3COOH. It gives you, see, whatever the substance it is giving here, suppose these are the residue plus your carbon dioxide. You are not knowing, suppose, what the residue is there. The question is given, if 6.3 gram of NaHCO3 added to 15 gram of acetic acid, then the residue is found to weigh 18 gram. This is your 18 gram. And this is your carbon dioxide you are forming. It's a reaction, it is a question it is given. So, in this case, don't worry about the product or what it is coming. If you write, you are knowing the reaction, then you can write the product is what. Simply, what will happen? Hydrogen will be removed from here and sodium, the positive ion will get attached to it. Your product will be what? CH3COONA. Okay? CH3COONA. And then you see, carbon dioxide is going and what is remaining? That is called to water plus H2O. If you are not remembering, if you cannot form it, then simply you write residue here and you calculate, because the question is asking that only. So what much amount of your carbon dioxide is released. So now you find out the total mass of the sodium bicarbonate. Sodium, first of all, find 23 is knowing you are, and hydrogen is 1, carbon is 12, oxygen is 48. The total is coming 8 plus 2, 10, 10 plus 1, 11. 0.3, 14, 4, 1, and 1 plus 4, 5, 6, 8, 84 gram is coming, okay. But no need of calculating this molecular mass. Simply write here 6.3 gram of NaHCO3 written, so 6.3 gram you write, and acetic acid is your 15 gram, so 15 gram you write, okay. This is your 18 gram and this is your X gram. So, as you are knowing, according to the conservation of mass, the total mass of the reactant is equal to total mass of the product. You can write this equation as, what do you write? 6.3 plus 15 equal to 18 gram plus x gram. Okay. Now, what it is coming? 15 plus, this is a 15 gram, this is also 6.3 gram. 15 plus 6, 21.3 gram equal to 18 gram plus x gram. That implies x gram equal to 21.3 gram minus 18 gram. That is coming 21 minus 18, 3.3 gram. So what exactly the carbon dioxide formed? So, the carbon dioxide, CO2, the mass of CO2, the mass of CO2 released equal to 3.3 gram. This is the answer. So, very simple process and you can find out it. And same question, just I am changing it to just C. It will change. This is the question, answer is this one is coming. Suppose I will say, what much quantity of acetic acid is required, okay, to form 18 gram of residue and x gram by your 3.3 gram of carbon dioxide. Suppose little changes I am bringing in the question. Now you have written it, now you see what the question is coming. I'm just changing it. What is coming? Let's see. If 6.3 gram of NaCO3 is added to, this is written, no, I'm changing it. Look at here. If a how much quantity of NaSCO3, or you can write here of CH3COH, okay, required to react with a NaSCO3. It's a very simple language I'm writing by, because you first to understand it. Sodium bicarbonate to form 18 gram of residue along with and here you write 6.3 gram of NaSCO3, okay, to form 18 gram of residue along with 3.3 gram of, along with the release of 3.3 gram of carbon dioxide. You see, I have changed the question in that way. This type of question also may come in your examination. How will appear this one? You see, how much, what quantity of acetic acid is required? How much you, instead, what quantity also you can write? What quantity of acetic acid is required to react with 6.3 gram of NaSCO3 to form 18 gram of residue along with the release of 3.3 gram of carbon dioxide? Very peculiar question. The same question is there, just I have changed it. It means what? While solving, how to solve it, you look at here. The question is asked here. The same equation will write first, after that. Here written 6.3 gram, but this part is not given. So you take it as x gram, and this is 18 gram, and here it is given 3.3 gram. So very simple it is. You see, same process. The according law of conservation of mass, what will do? The total mass of the reactant is equal to total mass of the product. That's why 6.3 gram plus x gram, that equal to 18 gram plus 3.3 gram. Okay, and then that implies x gram equal to 18 gram plus 3.3 gram minus 6.3 gram. So what will get now? 18 plus 3.3, 21.3 gram minus 6.3 gram. So it is coming around 21 minus 6, 15 gram. Okay. So in this way, you are solving this question. 15 gram, 21 minus 6, 15 plus 5 plus 1, yes, 6, 15 gram is coming. Okay. So this is the answer you are getting. And in this way, a number of questions you can solve. The different type of questions you can select. So, try to pick up some questions of conservation mass from your book, and try to start solving the questions. If any doubt is coming, then you can come to solve by, you can post the questions. And then that are getting through the WhatsApp or any kind of communications, and then I will try to solve it. Okay, thank you, dear students. Next class we will start your another second law of your law of chemical combination. Till then, bye.